In this video, I'm going to show two examples of how interest is calculated when there are several deposits and/or withdrawals within a short period of time with compounding interest. So here we have the start of this first example. Jay will invest $500 at 3.5% compounded daily for 70 days. With 40 days to go, $200 is added to the account. And with only 15 days to go, $300 is added. This is more like a regular individual's transactions in a savings account. The question is asking us how much interest will be earned in this scenario. This essentially is treated as three separate deposits, and the interest that each accrues or gains in the time period that it's in there. So here we have a graphical representation of what's going on. The first deposit of $500 is sitting in the account, compounding every day for the 70 days that it's in there. 40 days to go means we have $200 that now is starting to compound. And instead of adding it on to the previous deposit or the initial deposit of $500, we're going to treat it as though it was a standalone $200 deposit in an account of its own. Determine the amount of interest that it compounds during that time frame. And the third phase of this problem is the $300 deposit that's going to compound on its own for the 15 days that it's in there to the point of where we want to see what the total balance in this account is. So we're going to go to the table that shows 3.5% compounded daily. We have a special table for that. We will look for the N equal each one of these particular problems. So for the first one, our principal is 500. We would look at that table for N equals 70, which is this value. So if there'd only been the $500 deposit, this would be the amount of money that the individual would see at the end of 70 days. But 30 days in to this time period, they deposited an additional $200 that's going to compound for 40 days. So we will look up the number associated in the compounding daily table with 3.5% interest for 40 days. And here we have the value, times it by that principal deposit of $200, and do the same thing for the last one. The $300 will only be compounding for 15 days, so we will look up the number from the table associated with 15 days, multiply it by the principal amount. This would be the amount each one of these has grown to, but the balance in the account then is $1,004.57 when you add up these three transactions. We're not done though. It's asking us how much interest is earned in this entire 70 days and recognizing not all the money has been compounding for that full amount of time. To do this, we have to determine what the principal deposits were in this account. So adding those up, 500 plus 200 plus 300 gives us $1,000 of this individual, Jay's, money. If we subtract our principal from the balance, the difference of $4.57 is the interest that this money earned in this account. Here we have a second example, and it states on April 1st, MVP Sports opened a savings account with a deposit of $17,500, a withdrawal of $5,000 was made 21 days later, and another withdrawal of $980 was made 12 days before July 1. Find the balance on July 1. So to take a look at this problem, we kind of turn the tables around slightly. Instead of starting with the initial deposit and subtract those withdrawals, instead we look at how long the money is in this account before it is withdrawn. So in this first withdrawal, we're told $5,000 was withdrawn 21 days later after the start. Now we don't have the date on that, and it's not necessary. What it's telling us is that the $5,000 compounded for 21 days. We're going to calculate that. We're told another withdrawal of $980 was made 12 days before July 1. Well, we have 79 days here. Where did that come from? We have to do a little bit of calendar math. We need to determine what day 12 days before July 1st is. So if we look up July 1st, we find it's the 182nd day. 182 minus 12, the 12 days before that, tells us that that is the 170th day. That's the day the money was withdrawn. The initial deposit was made on April 1st. So we need to know what kind of time lapsed between when it was withdrawn on the 170th day and when it was deposited on April 1st or the 91st day. So 170 minus 91 is where the 79 days is coming from. Because that withdrawal of $980 was made 12 days before July 1, that money sat in this account from April 1st for 79 days, compounding. The last step we need to do is to determine what remains of that initial deposit that actually stayed in the account the entire time. So to calculate that, where did the $11,520 come from? The initial deposit was $17,500. We had withdrawals of $5,000 and $980, which leaves us with a net amount of $11,520 that was in this account from April 1st to July 1st. And if you do the arithmetic on those dates, you find it's 91 days. We're now ready to calculate the compounded amount of each one of these different values that we have. We will look up on our 3.5% compounded daily table the multiplier for 21 days and multiply it by the $5,000 that sat in the account for 21 days. While it was there, that $5,000 gained interest of $10.08. Do the same with the $980. We'll look up the value from the table that is associated with 79 days. We can see during the 79 days that the $980 was in the account. If I take 980 away from here, we see 745, and do the same with the net deposit that remained in the account the entire 91 days. This has grown to the amount shown there, $11,620.96. When we take our net amount, $11,520, times the value from the 3.5% compounded daily table associated with 91. We have two ways that we can find the balance on July 1st. We can add up these three values, but we do have to remember to subtract the two withdrawals from them, $5,000 and the $980 withdrawals, because they're no longer in there. We had to use them to calculate the interest, and that's probably the easiest method. Again, add up the three values and subtract the two amounts that were withdrawn, which will give you this amount, $11,638.49, or the other method would be to pull off the interest from the $5,000 that was earned during the 21 days it was in there, which I mentioned earlier was the $10.08. In the second one, pull off the interest from the second withdrawal while it was in there. When we take $980 away from this balance here, it's left with $745. We can add those interests of $10.08, $7.45 onto this net amount that remained in the account the entire amount, and we should also arrive at that same value.